to our channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Angela, and today we are going to be talking about some beginner classics. These are classics that I absolutely love. They are easy to read, quite accessible, and they're quite fast-paced. Most of these I read in one sitting. The first book that I want to recommend is The Street by Ann Petry. This is one of my favorite novels of all time. This book follows our main character, Ludie Johnson, who is a hard-working single mom. Every time I read this book, I cry and I sob and I become an absolute mess of a person. I've read this book twice now, and I've loved it each time. It is structured so well. The sentences are just hauntingly descriptive. Every time I pick up this book, I can clearly imagine the street in my head. It is just such stunning, sharp, tight prose. Every sentence draws you further into the story. Ludie is a very easy to love character. She just really wants what's best for her son. And to see the circumstances around her almost try to break her spirit is just so tough to watch unfold. This is very unsparing in its depictions of sexism and racism. Ann Petry is such a masterful storyteller. She really crafts a story that sucks you in. It's compelling, it's gripping, and this book kept me hooked from page one to the end. The themes and symbolism in this book is quite easy to grasp onto, which is what makes it a really accessible classic. Fair warning, this is quite a dark book because Ludie is fighting against a lot of malevolence, but the darkness of this book is rooted in reality, and that is what makes it such an impactful read. And I think a lot of the topics that are covered in this book are still relevant today, and I highly, highly recommend this book. This is one of my favorite books of all time. The next book that I want to recommend is a really short, very readable gothic novella called Carmilla. This is a vampire story that predates Dracula, and it is so good. The main intrigue of this book is the identity of Carmilla, and since we already know who or what Carmilla is, it's kind of easy to distance ourselves from the main buildup of the story, but I still highly recommend it. I love the sapphic undertones that this story explores. This is very much a classic gothic vampire story with all the classic gothic vampire elements, and it's just a very fun, very quick read with a lot of atmospheric tension that I just really enjoyed seeing play out in a 19th century story, which I really wasn't expecting, and it took me by surprise, and I absolutely loved it. There's also a really amazing web series that is based on this book, and I will link it down in the description box below. It is a pretty old web series, but it's one that I still absolutely love, and I highly recommend checking that one out as well. It's quite fan service-y in its execution of the book, but I still really enjoyed it. Hear me out on the next book that I want to talk about, because I know that the author's name is not usually associated with beginner classics, and that is The Gambler by Fyodor Dostoevsky. I absolutely love this book. This book follows a tutor who works for a Russian general, and it is about gambling addiction. And true the character dialogues and actions, you get to see the different stages of gambling addiction, and I think this is an absolutely brilliant novel. Now, the reason that I'm recommending it as a beginner's classic is because it is quite raw and personal, and the way that Dostoevsky describes gambling addiction feels almost diary-like, which I absolutely loved. Because Dostoevsky had to deal with gambling addiction himself, you can tell that a lot of this book really comes from the heart, and that breaks the barriers around this book in so many ways, and it lets us get closer to the work. And I think the intimacy of this book makes it an easier classic to engage with, and that's why I highly recommend it. I love this classic so much. It put me through a whole range of emotions. If you're looking to get into Dostoevsky, I highly recommend this book as a starting point, because I do think that this is one of his easiest novels to step into. The next book that I want to talk about is Breakfast at Tiffany's by Truman Capote. This is one that I listened to on audiobook, and I was honestly so surprised and taken aback by this work. It is so different from a movie. This book follows a narrator who is describing and sharing his memories of Holly Golightly, a society girl. At first, her life seems like it's very shallow, but the more that you dig into it, the more layers we see to Holly Golightly and what she's trying to escape from and why she leads this sort of existence. Holly Golightly in Capote's version is quite rough around the edges. She has more of this angsty teenage mood that I really enjoyed Audrey Hepburn really scraps all of that in her reimagining of Holly Golightly, and she brings this grace and elegance to the character that's not really seen in Capote's book. And while I love that interpretation of it, really loved the original as well. So expect that these two characters are completely different in almost a Jekyll and Hyde sense, but they're still very much lovable in their own right. Holly is a very complicated character, and she makes a lot of mistakes, and she does a lot of very trivial things, but that also has to do with her age. She is so young in this book. There was so much dialogue in this that I really enjoyed, and there were so many small moments in this book that I absolutely enjoyed, and I really do recommend it. It's a very quick read. I love Truman Capote's writing style. It's the right amount of descriptive for me, and I can really like get into it. This was a really good book. Highly recommend it. The next book that I want to recommend is Alice's Adventures in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll. You probably know the story as well. It follows Alice, who tumbles down after a rabbit into a hole and finds this wonderful, whimsical, magical, wacky, quirky world of Wonderland, and it's such an incredible place. This is a very odd book in the very best way possible, and I think you can come out of this book one of two ways. You can either think it was utter nonsense or absolutely brilliant, and I'm definitely in the absolutely brilliant camp because I love it so much, and I think there's a lot of nostalgia associated with this book that I just feel, and I love it, and I highly recommend it because I love the way that Lewis Carroll plays with language in this book. It's just a very playful book. You can tell that the author had a lot of fun twisting phrases that were common at the time and turning it into something unbelievably whimsical, and I absolutely enjoyed this book. I highly recommend it. The illustrations in this book are also absolutely fantastic. This is a children's classic, but it is so much more than that. I feel like you can read this book at any age and really enjoy it. The next book that I want to talk about is The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde is one of my favorite authors, and this is hands down one of my favorite books. This is the kind of book that you can easily read in one sitting because the concept of it is so simple yet so intriguing. In this book, Basil Hallward paints a portrait of Dorian Gray. The portrait ages, but Dorian himself retains a youthful beauty. This book is about hedonism and sensuality. It's about pleasure and vice. It's an exploration of aestheticism, and it's just so brilliantly done. This is a book that will keep you hooked and invested. I don't want to give away too many details about this book because experiencing it for the first time, that memory that I have of that is something that's very precious to me and something that I want to protect. So I'm not going to give away too many details about this book because I want you to experience the journey of reading this. It is a very short book. You will read it very quickly. If you're unsure of what to pick up first from this list and you're interested in a couple of recommendations, I highly recommend this one because it's the easiest to get into and fall in love with. The next book that I want to recommend is one that I read this year and I absolutely loved it, and that is All Quiet on the Western Front. This is such a brilliant novel about the cost of war. It follows Paul Bäumer, who is part of the German army during World War I. The writing of this book actually really blew me away. It's somewhere in between a diary and a log, and at times it's so matter of fact that it just hit me in the face, and it discusses the soldiers' conditions, and not just the living conditions, which were pretty abysmal, but also mental conditions. It's not difficult to read in terms of the writing, but it's difficult to digest in terms of its heft, and yet at the same time, it was a very gripping book. I just really, really love this book. It is so incredible. It is heartbreaking. It is heart-wrenching. This book made me think so much about war, about who are the players in war and who's benefiting from the war and who's actually fighting in the war. And there were so many things in between that this book made me think about and ponder, and there were so many thoughts moving through my head throughout. There are a lot of war stories that soften war under this veil of heroism. This book is not one of them, and that's partially why I loved it so much. It is quite graphic at times, and it's by someone who experienced World War I themselves. This book took a brutal beating at my heart, and this is definitely one of the best books that I've read in 2021, and I highly recommend this as a classic that's very beginner friendly. The next book that I want to recommend is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. The language of this is a little more old school. It's a little longer and more convoluted. But the reason that I'm recommending this as a beginner classic is because there are so many adaptations of this book, it's easier to follow along with the story. If you've watched any of the adaptations, and I'm sure you've come across them at some point, you might have a base idea of what's going on in the story, and you can follow along and then enjoy the wonderful banter between Elizabeth Bennet and Fitzwilliam Darcy. This this is not just a romance novel, it is also a discussion about the societal structure of the time and class. And it is just such a wonderful book. I love Elizabeth Bennet's dad so much. I love his dialogue so much. I love the histrionics of Elizabeth's mom. She's such a caricature, but it was done intentionally and it brought polarity to the novel in terms of her whinging. This was just such a great book. And I love that Elizabeth has to kind of break her judgments in order to get closer to Darcy. I don't think the romance in this book, me talking about it, is spoiling anything because at this point we all know who our two main love interests and leads are. This is a very slow burn romance, but it's one that's well worth it. You definitely feel all of the wonderful feelings in terms of this book. And I think that Jane Austen is just such a wonderful writer. She has all of that classic humor that I always talk about on this channel. I'm the kind of person who cries a lot while reading books. I don't laugh very often while reading books, and it takes a lot to draw a laugh out of me, but this book is absolutely hilarious, and it is funny, and it is witty, and it is wonderful, and I highly recommend it. But I'm a Jane Austen fangirl, so read it. The next book that I want to recommend is Little Women. It is so strange to me that Louisa May Alcott, the author of this book, was reluctant to write it because it is a book that has touched the hearts of so many people. This book follows four sisters, Jo, Beth, Amy, and Meg, and it chronicles their journey over quite a long period of time. Each of the girls in this book is quite distinct in terms of their personality. They have different dreams and aspirations. They have different directions that they want to go in life. And I love how they didn't fit neatly into a box. This is such a wonderful little story. This book is about a lot of love, and it also deals with these topics of grief and loss and courage, and there is just so much in this book that makes it such a very special book for me and one of the reasons why I highly recommend it. You feel so much reading this book, and this is also one of those books that you can come back to at many different points in your life. You can read it as a child and relate to certain aspects of it, and then as you're growing up you can relate to different parts of the story, and I think that's such an incredible thing to capture. The girls are kind of awkward, but they are also so strong-willed. Read it for Jo, read it for Beth, and read it for all of the characters. The last book that I want to recommend is A Raisin in the Sun by Lorraine Hansberry. This is one of my favorite plays of all time. This follows multiple generations of the younger family, and they are waiting for a check of $10,000 to come in, and they all have different ideas of how they are going to spend the money, but ultimately they want to spend this money in a way that's going to give them all a better life. The members of the younger family face so much disenfranchisement throughout this story, and it's heartbreaking to see because you can see them really, really trying to get to that better life. This is about dreams, trying to achieve those dreams, and can you achieve those dreams given the circumstances around you? It is a very, very impactful play. It is very moving. The members of the younger family are all interesting to see and to get to know, and this is definitely one of my favorite plays of all time. It is quite accessible. The language and the dialogue is easy to step into. You almost feel like you're stepping into the family in real time, and I really love that aspect of it, and that's why I highly recommend it. Let me know what beginner classics you would recommend in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye guys!